For a very long time, it is evident from the established facts and the estimated data that burning of carbon have caused serious hurdles in the working of climate and its components. And now is the time for us to realize that climate will not wait for us. We all are aware that carbon dioxide is the major culprit in harming the climate, which is primarily caused through burning of fossil fuels. If one will look at the definition of carbon tax, which is given by United Nations, it says that carbon tax curbs the greenhouse gas emissions by placing a fee on emissions and also providing an incentive on emitting less. If carbon tax is set adequately high, it will create a powerful monetary hindrance, which will further encourage the use of clean energy fuels by moving on towards the non-carbon fuels. The foundation of this concept of carbon tax is polluter pays principle, which is first implemented in the case of M.C. Mehta versus Union of India. It is estimated that an effective increase in carbon rate by Euro 1 per ton of carbon dioxide leads to an average reduction of 0.73% emissions across the globe. According to IMF, we need a global tax of US$75 per ton by 2030 to reduce emissions to a level consistent with 2 degrees Celsius warming target. Moreover, this tax policy helps the countries to generate revenue to overcome any economic hurdle. When we talk about carbon tax, India is one of the opposing countries so far, because carbon tax is against World Trade Organization rules. Although in 2010, Indian government introduced carbon cess, which only applied to the coal. Later in 2017, this cess was replaced by GST compensation tax up until 2022. This tax regime will now be collected till 2026, but the tax collected after June 2022 will not go to the states. On November 15th recently, Supreme Court has discussed on the issue if the carbon credit sale is taxable or not, stating on which Supreme Court has said that carbon credits can be used as a revenue asset for the country. However, the issue is yet to be decided. At COP26 Climate Change Conference at Glasgow, the Honorable Prime Minister have made some bold commitments, stating that by 2070, India will achieve the target of zero carbon emissions. India does not have an explicit carbon pricing, but it does have an array of schemes such as perform, achieve and target, internal carbon pricing, etc. The central challenge with carbon tax policy is its diffused benefits and concentrated costs. Carbon tax has been accused of being regressive by affecting lower income households. It can be concluded that India, being one of the hardest hit nations by climate change, should use its global monopoly to impose a carbon tariff as visioned by European Union to forge climate harm. It is efficiently required that India should utilize the revenue and identify the green projects across the country. India can also follow the handbook on taxation as developed by UN on the matters related to the introduction of carbon tax in the developing countries. Therefore, it is even more important for India to design policies in the most effective way to mitigate this to the best extent possible.